All power to the people. All power to the people.
All power to the people.
All power to the oppressed peoples of the United States of America.
All power to the people.
What we're looking at right now, people, what we're standing in right now, we look at this house, we are looking at what poverty looks like. This is what poverty looks like. The news lady asked me, she said, well, the Dallas Police Department, they've confiscated 1,400 kilos of crack cocaine down in Dixon Circle. They've gotten 300 guns down in Dixon Circle. Those people down there in Dixon Circle don't want to work. Why is that? Why is there so much crack cocaine? And why is there so many guns down in Dixon Circle? I said, well, you need to ask Ronald Reagan.
Yeah.
I said, you need to ask him about the Iran-Contra scandal. I said, matter of fact, you need to ask Free Ray Ricky Ross. You need to ask all of those people who had a hand in gun trafficking for crack cocaine to put AR-15s and assault rifles in poor people's communities, all the way from California to South Dallas. Right now, what we're looking at street economics. Because I'm quite sure if you would have asked James Harper, would you like a legal job? He would have said, hell yeah. Versus being in a crack house, having to sell crack to feed his family. I'm quite sure if you would have asked James Harper, would you rather not have a prison record or felonies and you'd rather have a clean slate and a good job? Hell yeah, you probably would have had that, but America does not give us those options.
Yeah.
If you are brown, if you're black, if you're poor, I don't care if you're from South Dallas to the Appalachian Mountains, where people can't even get health care. It's something wrong with that. But we as a people, when we stand up and we say something about our conditions, oh, them some bad niggas, they talk too much. Hell yeah, we're going to talk.
Hell yeah.
Hell yeah, we're going to talk. Hell yeah, we're going to talk about lack of health care. Hell yeah, we're going to talk about shitty ass education. Hell yeah, we're going to talk about lack of jobs. Hell yeah, we're going to talk about bad housing situations. Hell yeah. We've been saying hell yeah, talk about these things for 500 years, ever since they put us in the belly of a slave ship. And guess what? We're still in the belly of the beast. But you don't talk to them Sandinistas. You don't talk about them people, them choppers up there in the mountains. You ain't talking about the people over there in Syria who are getting down for theirs. They for real about revolution. Because what happens overseas happens over us. It happens here. And what do they say? The ruin of a nation starts in the homes of its people. It might be a small group of us, but goddammit, we're here. I don't live in Dixon Circle. But when I saw the shit jump up, I got into my car and came over here and got in the streets with the people. My mouth, my God, was a spook that sat by the door. And everybody needs to read that book. Because it tells you what to do in military occupation. It tells you that Sam Greenlee, when he wrote that book, he was on it. Because everything that happened down here that day happened in the spook that sat by the door. From shutting off all ends of the streets to bringing in the horses and the dogs. Military occupation. Anytime that you have people standing in the street and the police got riot gear and AR-15s in your children's faces, that is military occupation. This just ain't no drug trafficking no more. They scared. And this is the first time that I've seen people since Santos Rodriguez was assassinated back in the 1970s stand up. And it's a beautiful thing when we get brown, black, and white come together because everybody knows when you get us together, we're a hell of a mix. But Americans always try to keep us separated. But right now, guess what? This economic situation, you can't keep the black, the brown, and the white together apart. Because guess what? Everybody is fucking starving. Ain't nobody eating. This is what I'm talking about. This is economics right here. This is hard economics. If them brothers have been given an opportunity for a legal job, for a good opportunity, hell yeah, they wouldn't have been in there cooking up the crack cocaine that America gives them. That's real. But we don't fly the shit in like Wesley Snipes said it what was the movie he was in? New Jack City. We don't fly it in our planes. We
Thank you. Yes, yeah, exactly.
They know, but they ain't gonna tell us.
They ain't gonna tell us.
Numbers, they keep us deaf, dumb, deaf, and dumb, and blind, and when we killing each other, it's always gonna be that. But today, I'm proud to be here with my brothers and my sisters. I'm proud to be here. I'm proud to be standing here with everybody. I'm proud to be here. From Nat Turner, to Emmett Till, to Trayvon Martin, to Yusef Hawkins, to Sean Bell,
Tay Reynolds.
Too many to name.
Tobias Mackey, Lil Bobby Walker.
James Husbands.
Emilio Dalio,
what, shot 500 times?
Santos Rodriguez.
Little Mexican boy who was shot, handcuffed in the back of a damn Dallas police car. Does anybody talk about that?
I'm just
But see, this is what we talking about. This is what poverty looks like. This is what brought this boy to the end of his road. This is what a black man's life wound up at. And he died with his face in a pile of horse shit and a horse manure and a horse peeing at the back. Like a damn animal. He jumped three damn fences. But what happened was the law couldn't handle this Mandingo warrior. And what did he tell him on that day? He said, you're not finna put me back in chains. You finna have to do what? You finna have to kill me. Whether a dope dealer, a crack seller, or what, they didn't put that boy back in chains. They understood on that day, this black man was gonna fight. And he fought to the death. See, now we can die like slaves, and we can crawl up in our little old clapboarded ass houses. Or we can stand out here in the sun and get some melon and get our backbone straight and say, you know what? We the people. And we're tired of the bullshit. This is real, y'all. This is what poverty looks like. This is what poverty looks like. This is what a man's life added up to. Some flowers on some dead-ass graves. But when his family stood up and said, we want to know what the hell happened to our people, the people came in the streets. The people came in the streets. Because at some point in time, we get tired of running like dogs. We get tired of that. And at some point in time, we got to stand up and we got to say, you know what, James Harper, regardless of what America made you, you died like a soldier. You died with your fist in the air. You died letting them know, you're going to have to kill me on this day because I'm not going back in the belly of the beast for nobody. Because you made me. You made me. You gave me this life. And guess what? You're going to have to take this life. And that's what that is. So like I say, I don't live in Dixon Circle. I live in Oak Cliff. But all of us are Dixon Circle. All of us are South Central LA. All of us are Oscar Grant. All of us are Trayvon Martin. All of us are Tobias Mackey. All of us are Chairman Fred Hampton Sr. All of us. All of us are Lil Bobby Walker. All of us are Lil Bobby Hood. All of us. Because guess what?
Sister Olinka, I will say, you know what? I am not. And that's why I'm here today, because it's an unfair representation of who's killed in these streets.
You know what? Again, it's an unfair, but guess what? If you're poor and you're oppressed, you're still part of it. You're still part of it. That's the whole point of it. If we ain't got enough money for a lawyer to get us out of jail, if we ain't got Mitt Romney money, guess what? We still who we are. That's what I'm talking about. That's what I'm talking about. If you got to live from check to check, you are who we are. So I just want to say this. Is that this will probably look like. I want y'all to see this. I want y'all to actually look at this. This is a memorial to poverty. This is what happens to our people. This is what we wind up at. And we should not never let that happen again, but we should not forget this. This, like they say, is a hell of a Holocaust. This is a hell of a cost. So I just want to say, all power to the people. All power to the oppressed people. And let's keep on pushing and let's keep on doing what we need to do. Fight back. Ashe. My mommy named me Olinka. So that's my name. My name is Olinka DeLondon Green. And my mom was a revolutionary, and I ain't never told nobody this. But my mama robbed banks to fund her lifestyle. My mama repatriated from Dallas, Texas to California, where I lived for like 4 years as a boy because the FBI was looking for my mama. My mama was gangster for real. She was so gangster, you go up on the 7th floor at the Dallas Public Library, they got files up on my mama. My mama and daddy changed the laws up in Dallas, Texas, because before, it was legal for you to walk around with a solid shotgun, but my mama and them When they would repatriate their money, they would go in the banks and they would put the shotguns in the people's mouth and tape them up. And they would say, fuck you, give me what you owe me, because my baby need diapers. So that's the type of child that I am. So black power and mommy, I'm down here. Holla at y'all.
Next, I'd like to introduce from the Prisoners of Conscience Committee, Chairman Fred Hampton Jr.
Power to the people.
Power to the people.
Right on. Oh, man, where's Cisco? Hey, Cisco, this mic's still hot, man. Right on. I'm Chairman Fred Hampton Jr. of the POCC / BPPC. That's the Prisoners of Conscience Committee, Black Panther Party Cubs. I'm from Africa. I'm based in Chicago. Real brief history from where I come from. I'm the son of Chairman Fred Hampton. Chairman Fred Hampton was the deputy chairman of the Illinois chapter of the Black Panther Party, which was the largest chapter of the Black Panther Party. I'm also the son of Akua and Jerry, formerly known as Deborah Johnson. Chairman Fred was assassinated, and I stress that word, he was assassinated by the United States government December 4th, 1969, at the age of 21 years old, as a part of the vicious onslaught that this government had waged on our movements, our organizations, our people in general, and that being the COINTEL program, which is an acronym for Counterintelligence Program. And when I talk about that, I wish we could say how bad things used to be back in the 60s and how far we came. But as in this case of James Harper, as in the case of Michael Walken, who was gunned down by Chicago Police, Cabrini Green, this case was just, what's the brother's name, just in Arkansas?
Chavis Carter.
Chavis Carter, who they claim committed suicide.
In
handcuffs. These are blatant examples, you know what I'm saying, that the war, you know what I'm saying, on the black community in particular, and all the press communities in general, is still going down. I'm a humble servant of the people, to make sure that I came as a guest from Chicago, Illinois. I'm honored to be here, you know what I'm saying, doing a professional coalition with a number of different organizations and forces out here. We want to let the people know that we respect no colonial borders, you know what I'm saying, so wherever the people are attacked at, wherever they're at, nationally, internationally, you know what I'm saying? We got to make that connection because it's the...
Touch one, touch all.
Got to believe that because the government, the state, the system, they ain't set tripping. You know what I'm saying? They fucking over us in Mexico, Colombia, Africa, from the Congo to Chicago. So we got to make that connection throughout the communities all over the world. So I want to say that we got to hold people accountable. You know what I'm saying? A lot of times we can see the most direct attack that being going down on the people, that being the pigs, the police. In the Black Panther Party, they said, they talking about exposing the contradictions. Everything ranged from the demagogic politicians to the fascist pig cops to the avaricious greedy businessmen. We gotta call the question. We gotta say, I think I'm saying his name right, the preacher up here, Reverend Freeney. If he ain't said nothing about this case, we gotta expose him. The councilwoman, Carolyn Davis, she ain't said nothing about it, we gotta expose them. We gotta make the connection. We say the state, not just the police, not just the ones right in our face.
But all Dwayne Carraway, you put himself on Front Street.
Did I say it again?
Dwayne Carraway, you put himself on Front Street.
Okay, well, like I said, they gotta take a position with the people, I'm saying. Okay, if they did, right on. We say reward those who do the right things, repercussion for those who don't. You know what I'm saying? So everybody gotta commit a revolutionary act. We say even if it's some local hip hop artists in the city, they gotta talk about this shit that's going on in these communities, you know what I'm saying? And I ain't talking about no softball ass speech come through, you know what I'm saying? Just said, we talking about mothers dying. I mean, not that, mothers getting murdered. You know what I'm saying? So we gotta up the ante. A lot of times we just wait till Black History Month come around and can't say, okay, come out there, we acknowledge and assault in the same type of way. In fact, they had I draw the correlation to, they had Muhammad Ali on the Wheaties box some years ago. And the representative for the Wheaties cereal said, man, y'all, Muhammad Ali was an extraordinary athlete back in the 60s. Why y'all have him on that end? And the representative for Wheaties cereal said, we can put him on that now because he's safe. A lot of people talk about these issues in our community when it becomes safe to talk about it. Man, this shit is, we don't drink stale milk. We gotta address this shit when it's going down, when it's hot. Right. You know what I'm saying? So a lot of people addressing, you know what I'm saying, from a distance. I'm saying, from a concrete, tangible, taking a position, addressing this shit, this murder. Now, ain't talking about no beating around the bush. And we gotta also up the ante, be very clear, stop attacking the victims. You feel what I'm saying? Like, we got this thing we call the sidetracked of the slave. That means that, like, a lot of times when the pigs, when they bounced on Rodney King, you had motherfuckers asking, was he speeding or not? Yes. You feel what I'm saying? What type of activity Kessler's engaged in? We cannot take that position. We must take the principal courageous position. cocaine, half crack cocaine. The people said, we don't get no fuck if he's on heroin. Don't convict them pigs and see what's going to happen in this city.
Right on.
So we have to up the ante. And whatever contradictions, again, whatever issues the people have amongst each other. Right. We said the Black Panther Party said that differences amongst the people are reconcilable.
Right.
Differences between the people and the state are irreconcilable.
Yeah. Yeah.
What that means? What that means in plain layman's terms. What that means in plain layman's terms. We know that in this condition they got cats, you know what I'm saying, for get engaged in battle for strips and sets. We know we got issues between, you know what I'm saying, brothers and sisters. We know that issues between the black and brown community. But we must be very clear. We can work them out and deal with them contradictions. You know what I'm saying? But ain't no forgiving. There is no forgiving for a system. You know what I'm saying? That's snatched up and kidnapped forces such as me out with tomorrow, last Sunday out in Dakota, got Sada Shakur and forced political exile. No forgiving for that system. It's just this constant battle on the people. So again, whatever differences the people get, we'll work on it. The best way of working, the best therapy, the best way of working out is literally through the work. So again, I'm honored to be here. I'm going to invite y'all out tonight. I'm be at Pan-African Connections tonight on 4th Avenue. But again, I'm honored to be here. One of the things the POCC, BPPC, we honor ourselves about is coalition building. So again, we say power to the people, justice from Jack Harlow.